Hey Emma, did you know that more than 80% of online shoppers are reading your product descriptions before ever deciding whether they want to buy it or not?
No, but now that I'm thinking about it,
we should probably make them better.
Yeah.
That's what we're talking about today on The Journey. Running an e-commerce business, writing product descriptions can seem like a really boring thing to do or really monotonous, repetitive. You're like, ugh, I don't want to do that,
yeah.
Right? But they can make or break your online business. So they really have the power to turn someone from who's just browsing on your website into an actual customer.
Mm-hmm. So when it comes to making great product descriptions, there's really three pointers I like to make. Remember, storytelling, key, humanizes it, mm-hmm. rich content, and also SEO awareness.
In this video, we're gonna show you how to write product descriptions that actually translate into more traffic and more sales for you. So as Emma mentioned, the first key is learning how to write product descriptions that tell a story. So you're not just focusing on the product itself, but you're actually focusing on the experience.
Yeah, you really wanna make it easy for your customers to envision themselves using your product.
And look at how Birchbox used this example to help sell this beach wave spray from Bumble and Bumble, right? Mm-hmm. So they're talking about really all those different sights and smells of the ocean. They're talking about the coconut and mango texture. They're really putting you in that actual experience rather mm-hmm. than just trying to sell the product.
I feel like you're in the experience too. Can you smell that?
Yes.
Wow. You smell coconut?
Are we on the beach?
We're on the beach.
The next part of mastering product descriptions is consider who your target customer is.
Yeah, and don't just stop there, right? Like consider how the customer is going to use that product. And one thing that comes to mind, I know we were talking about this mm-hmm. earlier, think about the iPhone.
Exactly. So Apple, for the iPhone 11, they're really focusing here on this product description about the dual camera
yeah.
and the high quality video and how that helps really capture life's moments that you can't miss, right? Mm-hmm. And then they're also talking about how the battery life lasts all day, so it saves you more
precious time.
Yeah. These are the things that matter to customers, so they're highlighting those in order to show them how this is actually going to benefit them. Our next tip is make sure that your product descriptions match your tone and your buyer's persona, right? So you have these ideal customers. Well, you know, what is their tone and how does that match with your brand? Use that in your product descriptions.
Totally. And thinking about millennials, they enjoy a little humor. So inject humor, inject fun into those products, especially if they're lifestyle products.
Yeah, so one of my favorite Austin ice cream companies is actually dairy-free, gluten-free. There you go. Did this one for you, Emma.
Thank you, Alex.
And it's super delicious, right? So their ideal customer is like Austinites.
What's the name?
It's called Natamu.
Natamu.
Yeah.
Oh my
and
gosh,
so,
that's brilliant.
Exactly. And it's actually really delicious as well. So with their cookie dough fudge ice cream, mm-hmm. obviously super delicious, in their product description, they're saying, "Oh, fudge, that's what you're going to be saying when you open up this pint, right?"
I get it.
Oh, fudge. On the other hand, though, if you do sell a more serious product, not cool ice cream.
Reel it in.
If you sell some professional tech products, you got to reel it in, of course. You know, make it a little more serious, match that tone of the buyer that you're trying to connect with.
Another thing to keep in mind with your product descriptions, keep it concise and scannable. And one way I like to look at this, think about what's going to really hook your audience. What's going to attract them? What's that elevator pitch in a way, you know?
Oh, yeah.
You only have so much time to catch the buyer's attention with these short attention spans today. So what is that?
Exactly. I feel like you have 5 seconds before someone decides whether or not they're pressing that back button. So you definitely want to put all of that, that really detailed, concise information first mm-hmm. so that they know all the important information really quick. You get to the point and then you can go a little bit
more
detailed.
Yeah, you can add more later.
Yeah, of course. If people are interested, they're going to want to read that more, but you got to hook them first.
Also, when it comes to scannability, think about it. Customers today, they're on the go, they're on their phones, so make it easy for them to see those product descriptions from their mobile device.
Yeah, 79% of mobile users have made a purchase on their phone within the last 6 months. I know I am always buying things on Amazon on my phone, right?
What was your last thing that you bought on your phone on the go?
It was actually, speaking of on the go, a little mini travel fan that you can bring
You've
with
been
you for
one
hotels.
Of those.
Exactly. And so, you know, their product description, it just blew me away.
Also, high quality images are really key for consumers because think about it. you have a product description, sure, like I can usually start to visualize something, but I want to be able to see it. A majority of people that are going into stores, like consumers, they want to be able to reach out and grab it. So, and it's like 62%, 62% of consumers are going to a brick and mortar store. They want to be able to see it, touch it, feel it. So you got to have those high quality images to bring those product descriptions to life.
Yeah, and if you don't have quite the budget for a professional photographer, you always have that handy dandy portrait mode on your iPhone.
Love portrait mode.
It's a great way to make it seem like you're a professional photographer when you're not and show off those high quality photos if you can't quite go the professional photographer route.
Another strategy includes user-generated content. So like customer testimonials, reviews, which makes a ton of sense. Like I'm more likely to spend money on your product if I see that your customers are raving about it. And the other way around too. Like if I'm reading a lot of customer complaints, I'm probably gonna keep shopping. But also there was a stat I read as high as 90% of people who read user-generated content or reviews trust it. And they entrust the business more than like if they just read about the brand or product on the website.
Yeah, one of my favorite places to online shop for clothes is Lulu's, right? So the reason is because not only do they have, of course, they have the model pictured with all the clothes, but then right next to it, they have fan photos. So this is real life people posting photos of that article of clothing on them. So that way you get a better idea. We're not all like models, right? So then you can tell how this product actually looks in person. The next key is making sure that your product descriptions are searchable with some SEO. Right? So if you want people to actually find your products, you have to sprinkle in a little SEO here and there. I know whenever I'm searching for, like, I have a wedding coming up that I have to go attend to.
Oh my God, I thought you were going to say you were getting married.
Nope. So I was looking
like,
for
what?
Surprise. No, I was looking for a dress, right? And so I was like, put yourself in the mind of that customer. So I was searching, like, wedding guest dresses, things to wear. You know, it's
don't
just
look better than the
right,
bride.
Exactly. So whenever you're writing those product descriptions, think about those types of things that people may be searching for.
Yeah, and then index each product, right? So on each page, because that's going to help with SEO as well. But go back to the context and the content that you're using. What are searchable words? What are those key words? And embed that in there for that SEO optimization.
So lastly, you've developed the perfect, beautiful product description. Now add in some of those useful and technical details, right? I mean, let's be real. The details matter to people. That can make or break whether someone actually buys your product.
Yeah, think about something like, I don't know, shampoo. There's a ton of shampoo out there that you can purchase. But one thing I look at was this tested on animals. So it needs to be information that can readily available that I can read. Also just thinking ahead, like what would my customers ask? What would they want to know? And make sure that's really easy to find on your product descriptions.
Right, like skin allergies would be
a good example
for clothing, right? They need to know what's going into those products.
Yeah, I went through a whole detergent thing on that where I had to like get the and doesn't smell as good, but you get without the like, But I had to find that product description for me in order to do my laundry, which is time sensitive.
Yeah, and if you can't find that product description, you may just hit the back button and go buy it somewhere else. Now that you have all these great ways to write product descriptions, put them to the test. Use some A/B testing to see which one works best for your business.
Yeah. And there's some tools out there like Optimizely, Google Optimize that can help you do this A/B testing.
Or you can even do an informal A/B test. Mm-hmm. Use it for similar products. Try out different variations for product descriptions and see which one really connects with your customers. So of course, product descriptions are not one size fits all, but they do have the power to be a game changer for your e-commerce business. They can really decide whether or not someone is actually gonna buy your products or not.
Totally, and don't get disheartened. For one, you have this guide to help you out. But remember, a little persistence, hard work, positive attitude, you can help to get these conversions with great product descriptions. So be sure to like this video, comment below on what you learned that was your favorite tip, and share it with someone you know who's trying to sell some products.
And while you're at it, subscribe to our channel and ring that bell so that you're the first to know whenever we upload more videos. Thanks for watching the journey. We'll see you next time.